go home. Slow down, someone could be there. You're in nothing, you're in no gear at all. It's about to hit a sign.
Taking the kids for their first driving lesson. It's a rite of passage for many families.
Never again.
But thanks to coronavirus, some learner drivers have hit a few speed bumps. In Victoria, parents can teach their children only if they're undertaking an essential activity like grocery shopping. And in Queensland, the supervising driver must live with the learner driver, and the journey must be within 50 kilometres of the family home. But there's another way children can become familiar with the road rules, and they can do it from home.
Have you still got a look?
Yep.
Thank God you look.
Our tech expert Trevor Long has signed up his 13-year-old son Jack to the myDRIVESCHOOL program, an educational game designed to reduce driving anxiety in teenagers by getting them used to real-life driving scenarios. And for Jack, it's quite a gear change from the F1 games he usually plays.
You've got to more think about how much you're putting on the throttle instead of just flat out and slamming on the brakes as late as you can. You've got to ease on to the brake and throttle. So it's like completely different to how I'm used to.
The first thing I noticed was he had to drive slowly, 40 kilometres an hour, up to a stop sign. And he did that well, but he stopped at the stop sign in like 3 metres, because in a Formula One game, you brake as late as you can. That was the first immediate learning for him. And that happened on a computer for him. Imagine that was a car. I don't know that I'd be prepared for that as a parent, for him to not brake until the very last minute.
Can you code that into the AI?
Lisa Scaife is the founder, teaming up with professional gaming developers to make her passion project become reality.
I grew up in motorsport. I've spent 25 years in professional racing. And at 22, I was actually involved in a road trauma fatality. And now I've got two teenage sons. And boys are killing themselves 4-1. So this was an area where I thought I could actually make a difference.
The racing games, you're often travelling at 100, 200, 300 kilometres per hour. In myDRIVESCHOOL, we need to train people to obey the speed limits, keep an eye on the speed limits, understand that you might need to do 40 kilometres per hour in some sections, and also understand that's really easy to go over the speed limit. That can happen just in the blink of an eye.
Now wait and keep your eye on the traffic light for
The green arrow. However, a word of warning from the NRMA.
Success once again, I think.
If you want to use this as a game with an education message behind it, that's fine. We're not saying that it should be a substitute in any way for the comprehensive and thorough and research-backed tools that are now available to the community in order to help young people become good drivers.
We should have more driver training. This should be the first step. You should be doing this kind of thing before you get behind the wheel of a car. And when you get behind the wheel of a car, you should be doing professional training and more of it. So I don't think this is a replacement. I think this is complementary and a big part of making the road safer.